Hey guys, this is Jake with Bitterroot Rambler, and this is my little wood stove that I made. I was watching these videos by a YouTuber named Average Iowa Guy, and he did a video on how to make one of these little mini keg wood stoves. Thought that was pretty cool, and decided to make my own. This is actually one of those Heineken draft kegs. The best part about this project is, of course, you guys make all the beer out of the keg before you can make the wood stove. But I watched that video and I thought to myself, gosh, it'd be kind of cool to make this and somehow incorporate it into the van as maybe a secondary heat source, because I am going to put a propane heater in it. The one thing I hate about propane heaters is that's the amount of moisture they give off. And so I thought maybe I could use a propane heater and then use this wood heat intermittently and kind of maybe dry the van out, because those the moisture from the propane stove can cause a lot of rust issues. So I thought I'd show it to you. Pretty much everything that I have incorporated into this stove I got from a place called Home Resources. They're here in Missoula, and they are a nonprofit that basically deals in recycled building material. So the legs on this, the pipe stove, the stove pipe, all that stuff is from Home Resources. I think it cost me, not including the keg itself, which you could find probably out of a garbage can if you wanted to, have a party and have some guys chip in on beer and have a free mini keg. I think altogether it was like $6, $7 to build this. I did go out and buy a piece of 26 gauge flat stock steel to make the stove coal here. I'll show that to you. This is kind of a prototype. Probably gonna make another one. I don't know if I will or not. This one works pretty good. But the way this thing works is, this just comes off like that. Here's my stove coal. I don't know if you can see inside there or not, but I have a piece of expanded metal in the bottom. I also put a baffle on the top. The baffle, when the wood burns, makes the heat go from one side to the other side and then out the top. One side to the other side, and up top like that. And I've burned it a couple times already. Burns really well. Burns really hot. I'm getting like burn times of like an hour and a half out of it, and that's from starting it till there's only a few coals left in the bottom of it. It actually works pretty good. So here's the cover. I put holes in the side of it, of course, so I could dampen how much oxygen gets into the stove. It works really well. You could make some kind of decorative hole pattern. I just drilled a bunch of holes in it just because I was impatient and wanted to get the project done. Make sure you make your handle big enough or far enough away from the cap so that it doesn't get hot. You don't burn yourself when trying to take the cap off. Probably always work well when you're stoking the fire anyway. And then don't forget to flare out the end of the cap, and then do the opposite for the stove coal. And that way you're not constantly doing this type of thing, you're trying to get on it. Slides on pretty easily. So that's my little wood stove. If you have any questions or anything about it, let me know. I'm gonna go out and burn it and show you guys how well it goes.
It's all set up here. Got a cinder block on it here because the stovepipe's not connected to anything. I'm gonna light this off. I stuck maybe 2-3 pieces of paper in there, twisted them up, and stuck them in there, and some scrap paper or scrap wood on top. Just light the wood off it. Fire will work. This barbecue lighter is working. Let it be for a few minutes, let it get started. I'll put the cover on.
Got it started here. Still burning off on the back bottom side of the stove. Still burning some of the paint off. You see that smoke behind it. But fire's going pretty well.
Inside.
You see how it's moving around that baffle.
And you can probably hear it too.
And the sign said, long-haired freaky people need not apply.
I don't know if you hear that or not.
So I tuck my hair up under my hat, and I went
kind of making the sound of a distant jet flying through the air.
Upstanding young man, I think you do.
Which means it's getting a really good draft.
So, I took off my hat,
so
said,
I'll show you the top of the stovepipe here. And as you can see, hardly any smoke coming out of the top of it, which means you're getting full combustion of the wood and the smoke inside the stove. So yeah, like I said, I'm not gonna go too much into like how I built it or anything, just because average Iowa guy did a really good job on his. So, let me check his out. But here's my wood stove. It's burning really well. So if you're wondering what kind of wood burns a best, or what kind of wood burn best in here, I use just a scrap 2x4. You can get a lot of scrap 2x4 from behind businesses that palletize a lot of their material. It comes in on trucks and whatever. You usually go back there and there's a pile of it. Or if you know somebody, they can get you some, that'd be cool too. But you just, you can take those scrap 2x4s, you can cut them to length with a chop saw, do a whole bunch of them. And then you can split, smaller pieces for starting the fire, and then usually just splitting them right in half once the fire gets going. Works really well. So, yeah. All right, so I just wanted to show one more shot of this thing burning. I've got it dampened down. And there's absolutely no smoke coming out of the top of that.
If you're going
burning very efficiently right now.
Francisco,
and so I'll just take off the cap here, and one more shot of the inside. Stuck a piece of wood in there. And everything's burning really nicely. Right. So this is Bitterroot Rambler. Check out my channel. And I got lots more stuff coming up. Check out the new product review I just did too on a battery pack. Alright, thanks. Gentle.